तो इसलिए सीरियस प्लेयर जो रहेंगे वो करेंगे। तो गवर्नमेंट ट्रांसफॉर्मेशन फेस इस समय चल रहा है, ये सारा ट्रांसफॉर्मेशन फेस है, और आने वाले किसान के आने वाले समय में ये बिज़नेस इतना स्ट्रीमलाइन हो जाएगा, इतना कॉर्पोरेट स्ट्रक्चर्ड कल्चर में इसमें काम होगा कि बहुत अच्छा बिजनेस होगा और उनके लिए अच्छा होगा। जो लोग इस समय दबे जो अच्छा काम कर रहे थे और जो ख़राब काम कर रहे थे उनमें कोई डिफ्रेंशिएशन भी नहीं हो पा रहा था। उसमें अच्छा काम करने वाले पिस रहे थे, उनका मकान कोई नहीं लेता, नहीं तो कोई महंगा होता था उनका, तो सस्ते वाले चक्कर में आ जाते थे लोग जो है, जिसकी वजह से आज ये रिजल्ट जो दिखाई दे रहा है वो हो रहा है। मतलब ऐसा भी है कि जो कंस्ट्रक्शन कॉस्ट है उससे कम में भी लोगों ने बेचा है। कंस्ट्रक्शन कॉस्ट कोई भी 2000 रुपये से कम में कंस्ट्रक्शन कॉस्ट कहीं नहीं आती है, लेकिन बहुत जगह 2000, 1800, 2500 में बेच दिया लोगों ने, बन ही नहीं सकता, वो थे बनेगा नहीं वो चीज़। तो ये बहुत अच्छा है कि अब सीरियस तरीके से काम किया जाए, और ये लाइन ये देश के लिए भी अच्छा है। GDP में सबसे ज़्यादा ग्रोथ इसके अंदर कंट्रीब्यूशन है, एम्प्लॉयमेंट सबसे ज़्यादा जनरेट करता है, और बहुत सारी डाइवर्सिफाइड इंडस्ट्रीज़ हैं जो कि इनडायरेक्टली या डायरेक्टली इसके साथ जुड़ी हुई हैं।
थैंक यू सो मच सर। हमने एक इंडस्ट्री वेटरन से सुना जो रियल एस्टेट में पिछले 20 साल से काम कर रहे हैं। नाउ देयर इज ऑल्सो एन इंडस्ट्री अपस्टार्ट जिनका कोई रियल एस्टेट में बैकग्राउंड नहीं था। ये रियल एस्टेट इनका बैकग्राउंड था कि ये रियल एस्टेट के रेजिडेंशियल प्रॉपर्टीज बेचते थे, पर इन्होंने एक अफोर्डेबल हाउसिंग में अपना नाम ऐसा किया है विच इज़ सिग्नेचर ग्लोबल, विच इज़ अ लर्निंग फॉर पीपल हु हैव बीन इन द रियल एस्टेट बिजनेस फॉर डेकेड्स। प्रदीप जी, व्हाट वाज योर फिलॉसफी, आपने क्या किया जो दूसरे नहीं कर सके, एंड व्हाट इज़ योर मंत्र ऑफ सक्सेस?
देखिए, बेसिकली हम लोग, जिसे आपने बताया कि रियल एस्टेट से नहीं है, लेकिन बाय लक कहें कि एक ऐसी मार्केट में पूरा का पूरा एक लास्ट लाइफ के 25 ईयर्स हमने स्पेंड किए हैं जो सबसे ज़्यादा रेगुलेटेड है, क्योंकि फाइनेंशियल मार्केट आप देखिए सेबी के अंडर काम करती है। वहाँ पे आप सिस्टम समझ सकते हैं कितने प्रॉम्प्ट हैं, इवन चाहे पे इन पे आउट के सिस्टम भी हों तो मिनट्स पे चलते हैं, अगर आप एक मिनट से डिफ़ॉल्ट करते हैं तो यू आर डिफ़ॉल्टर। और ऐसे टाइम में आप रियल इस्टेट जो जिन्हें कंप्लायंस क्या चीज़ होती हैं, शायद वो कंप्लायंस को अंडरस्टैंड भी नहीं करना चाहते, क्योंकि कंप्लायंस उनके लिए एक बहुत सेकेंडरी पार्ट में रहता है। जैसा प्रशांत जी ने बहुत अच्छा अभी सारी चीज़ें एक्सप्लेन की कि रेरा आने के बाद ये चीज़ बिल्कुल क्लियर हो गई कि अब वही लोग इस इंडस्ट्री में सर्वाइव कर पाएंगे जो कंप्लायंट हैं, और जो वो कमिटमेंट कर रहे हैं अपने कस्टमर से वो उसे डिलीवर कर पाएंगे। तो अगर दूसरा इसका एंगल देखें तो उन लोगों के लिए जो लोग सीरियस हैं, उन लोगों के लिए एक बहुत बड़ा रोड वहाँ पे ओपन हो गया, और उन लोगों के लिए जो केवल फ्लाई बाय नाइट डेवलपर बने थे वो लोग कहीं ना कहीं अब साइडलाइन हो जाएंगे। तो ये सबसे बड़ी बात थी इंडस्ट्री के लिए। जैसे मैंने बताया कि हम लोग फाइनेंशियल मार्केट से थे, तो जो अफोर्डेबल हाउसिंग है हमने इस पर बहुत रिसर्च किया, एक साल तक डोर टू डोर भी रिसर्च किया, इन ऑफिस भी रिसर्च किया कि इसमें डिमांड कितनी है। तो हमें अपनी रिसर्च में ये समझ में आया कि इस देश में कम से कम 95% जनता ऐसी है जिसे अफोर्डेबल हाउसिंग की नीड है, और देश के 1% से भी कम डेवलपर ऐसे हैं जो इस अफोर्डेबल हाउसिंग को क्रिएट कर रहे हैं। तो आप बना कितना सकते हैं ये डिपेंड करता है, डिमांड और सप्लाई में इतना बड़ा ह्यूज गैप है कि उसे आप फिल ही नहीं कर सकते। तो जो सर्वे हमने कराया उस सर्वे में ये लगा कि लोगों को लगा कि ये फ्लैट बन ही नहीं सकता, विद इन सिटी कैसे पॉसिबल है। तो हरियाणा गवर्नमेंट की जो पॉलिसी आई उस पॉलिसी ने इसमें बहुत बड़ा रोल प्ले किया। विद इन सिटी अफोर्डेबल हाउसिंग प्रोवाइड कराना, जैसे जो भी आप सेक्टर्स आप गुड़गावा के नाम लें, 107, 71, 81 ऐसे प्रॉम्प्ट सेक्टर हैं जहां 2 BHK यूनिट की कीमत 50 लाख 70 लाख 80 लाख रुपए से कम है ही नहीं, लेकिन इस पॉलिसी की वजह से ये यूनिट 22 लाख रुपए से 25 लाख रुपए के बीच में प्रोवाइड हो सकती है। कुछ FAR का भी इसमें एक नॉर्म था, लेकिन गवर्नमेंट ने जो प्राइस का रैशनिंग किया उससे भी कहीं ना कहीं एक चीज़ क्लियर हुई। दूसरी बात, गवर्नमेंट का इसमें पार्टिसिपेट करने से लोगों के अंदर एक ट्रस्ट भी बना रहा कि लोगों को लगा कि नहीं, अगर ये जो डेवलपर हैं अगर इस पॉलिसी में जा रहे हैं तो या तो ये डिलीवर करेंगे, अगर फेलियर होगा तो गवर्नमेंट हमारे साथ खड़ी है। तो ये भी हमारे लिए एक बहुत प्लस पॉइंट रहा। इन सारी चीज़ों को नापतौल के जब हमने देखा तो मुझे लगा ये एक ऐसी इंडस्ट्री है अगर इसमें जाया जाए तो शायद कुछ ना कुछ ऐसा मिल सकता है जो शायद जो अदर डेवलपर्स नहीं देख रहे हैं। आज से 3 साल पहले की जो कन्वर्सेशन होती थी तो उसमें मैं बहुत बार डिस्कस करता था कि जितने भी डेवलपर्स हैं उन लोगों के लिए बहुत बड़ा काम है। आप मुझसे 10 साल बाद की पूछें तो रियल इस्टेट में केवल अफोर्डेबल हाउसिंग ही ऐसा सेक्टर होगा जो पूरी की पूरी रियल इस्टेट को लीड करेगा, बिकॉज ट्रिलियन ऑफ ट्रिलियंस का बिजनेस इसके अंदर है। 2022 की बात करें तो 250 बिलियन का बिजनेस है, ये सबसे बड़ी इंडस्ट्री ये बनने वाली है। लेकिन नेचुरली बात है कि डेवलपर या तो पुराने अपने जो काम हैं उनसे स्टक हैं तो नए वो काम में इंटरेस्टेड नहीं हैं, या अफोर्डेबल हाउसिंग में जैसे मार्जिन है वो कम है तो ऑलरेडी वो इतने हायर मार्जिन पे काम कर चुके हैं कि उनको ये मार्जिन समझ नहीं आते हैं। और तीसरी बात कि आप इस बिजनेस को क्या छोटा करना चाहते हैं बड़ा, ये भी डिपेंड करता है। अफोर्डेबल हाउसिंग में अगर आप एक छोटा बिजनेस करना चाहते हैं 1,000-2,000 यूनिट का तो वो आपके लिए सर्वाइवल का रीजन भी नहीं हो सकता। अगर आप इसमें एक माइंडसेट को एक लॉन्ग टर्म वे से बिगर वे में लेना चाहते हैं एज ए इंस्टीट्यूशन तो मुझे लगता है ये इतना बड़ा बिजनेस है शायद अभी भी डेवलपर्स इस बिजनेस को समझ नहीं पा रहे हैं। हाँ नो डाउट चैलेंजेस हैं, रीज़न क्या है कंस्ट्रक्शन कॉस्ट जैसा प्रशांत जी ने बताया कि बड़ा मुश्किल है उसको नीचे लाना, लेकिन एक चीज़ ज़रूर है कि अगर आप इसे हाई वॉल्यूम के ऊपर कर रहे हैं तो मुझे लगता है वहाँ पे आपका जो कंस्ट्रक्शन कॉस्ट है वो कहीं ना कहीं डाउन जाती है। दूसरा ये बिजनेस जो है ये साथ में हाई लिक्विडिटी का भी है तो इसमें जो आपकी बाइंग पावर है वो ज़्यादा बेहतर हो पाती है कंपेयर टू अदर प्रोजेक्ट्स। अभी जैसे पहले के सेशन में डिस्कस हो रहा था कि जो प्रोजेक्ट्स में जिनमें बार बार चेंजेस होते हैं उनमें एक लॉन्गर पीरियड चल जाता है कि आज एक 100 फ्लैट बिके फिर दोबारा से उसको रिवाइज़ किया फिर दूसरे तरीके से बनाया, उससे प्रोजेक्ट कभी भी पूरे होने की तरफ नहीं आते। इस पॉलिसी का सबसे बढ़िया खूबसूरती ये है कि वेरी फर्स्ट डे जो डिज़ाइन है वही डिज़ाइन आपको डिलीवर करना है, उसमें एक इंच भी ना आप इधर कर सकते हैं ना इधर कर सकते हैं। तो इससे जो डेवलपर है उसके चार्ज उसको कम से कम टाइम भी लगता है। हाँ टेक्नोलॉजी का इसके अंदर इन्वॉल्व होना बहुत ज़रूरी है, अदरवाइज जो ट्रेडिशनल कन्वेंशनल अगर हम काम करना चाहें तो शायद ये इतने टाइम में अगर जो 4 साल का गवर्नमेंट ने टाइम दिया है उसमें बनाना इतनी बड़ी हाउसिंग पॉसिबल नहीं है। तो टेक्नोलॉजी ने इसमें रोल प्ले किया है, जैसे अभी हम लोग सारी की सारी अल्मोनियम फोम शटरिंग से कंस्ट्रक्शन कर रहे हैं और जो शटरिंग है वो भी मलेशिया और साउथ कोरिया से ही इंपोर्ट कर रहे हैं, लोकल शटरिंग भी यूज़ नहीं कर रहे हैं। तो जो क्वालिटी ऑफ प्रोडक्ट है एंड कंज्यूमर को जो जा रहा है वो बहुत क्लास जा रहा है। तो उससे उसके वो सारी की सारी चीज़ें जो अप्रीशन रहते हैं कि अफोर्डेबल हाउसिंग है 25 लाख 22 लाख की यूनिट है तो क्वालिटी तो होगी नहीं, तो मुझे लगता है वो सारी की सारी चीज़ें वहाँ पे बिल्कुल दरकिनार हो जाती हैं जब वो उस सोसाइटी पे पहुँचता है, उस सोसाइटी को देखता है। जैसे अभी आपने बताया कि कल हमने एक पहला प्रोजेक्ट डिलीवर किया है जो दिल्ली NCR की अफोर्डेबल हाउसिंग का और ख़ास करके हरियाणा की अफोर्डेबल हाउसिंग का पहला प्रोजेक्ट है। 1,000 यूनिट हमने इसमें डिलीवर की हैं। क्वालिटी ऑफ कंस्ट्रक्शन मैं बहुत भरोसे के साथ कह सकता हूँ कि जितनी भी ग्रुप हाउसिंग जो बेस्ट बनती हैं उनमें किसी भी तरीके से वो कम नहीं है। कोई भी ऐसे मानक जो सुरक्षा के होते हैं वो कम नहीं रखे गए हैं। हाँ आप उसमें क्लब नहीं दे सकते तो मुझे नहीं लगता मेरे जो कस्टमर हैं उनको क्लब नीड है आज की डेट में तो, और स्विमिंग पूल्स वगैरह ये नहीं हैं, लेकिन ऐसी बेसिक जितनी सुविधाएं होती हैं वो वहाँ पे हैं। तो आज जितने भी डेवलपर हैं मैं फिर इस प्लेटफॉर्म से ये कह रहा हूँ इस बिजनेस को लॉन्गर एंगल से देखें। आज अगर 1-2 साल के एंगल से देखेंगे लगेगा उनको प्रॉफिट मार्जिन नहीं है, लेकिन जैसे मैंने सोचा है मुझे लगता है ये इंडस्ट्री 2030 तक बहुत बड़ी इंडस्ट्री बनने वाली है। तो शायद डेवलपर्स के लिए बहुत बड़ा काम है और यही एक ड्रीम हम लेके चले थे और इसी वजह से आज यहाँ पे हैं नॉन रियल इस्टेट होने के बावजूद भी।
थैंक यू।
सॉरी
Sir, we'll take the questions afterwards.
Okay.
इसके बाद में questions ले लेंगे.
Around 950 square feet.
We heard from the man who's synonymous with Noida, Mr. Tiwari. We heard with the person who's made the mark in affordable. And now we'll also hear, and we'll come to Augustine. You know, Augustine, he can give us a perspective of a different market. But first, we'll come to Ananta. And Ananta, you spent most of your career with DLF, which was synonymous with Gurgaon, which created Gurgaon, which made more of a mark in the higher end, in the luxury kind of market, and of course, in the commercial space. What are your thoughts on this whole thing?
Good evening, my fellow panelists, all my dear friends in the audience. As far as the business of building, developing, and providing housing is concerned, we just need to change our focus completely from thinking of this whole business as a brick and mortar business, to completely thinking of it as a people-centric business. It's actually, there are so many industries which are aligned to the people they are catering to, whether it is hospitality, whether it is tourism, whether it is healthcare, all of these retail also. Everything that they are doing it keeping the end customer in mind. And I think that is the paradigm shift that we all really need to work towards. And that is something which is a big concern because, you just mentioned, whatever we are seeing today, which is really nice and which is worth appreciating, it's actually like retrofuturism. In the past, something very interesting was thought as a dream, and then that dream was created on ground, which we appreciate. But today, how many of us are actually dreaming and thinking of creating something which is, 25 years forward, or, like he just mentioned, 2030. Are we actually planning for all of that? When air taxis will be there, when driverless cars will be there, are we thinking? Are we educating people? Are we understanding what our customer needs? What type of housing will this new generation need? So from plots to independent houses, to floors, to high-rise apartments, to sky-rise apartments, everything has changed very dramatically in the last three decades. I'm one of the lucky few who has seen these three decades. And so that I feel, that personally I feel that planning for the future, understanding what the customer needs and creating that on ground. Do they need really small houses? Do they need micro homes? Do they need really lavish houses? Do they need personal pools? So whatever you are doing, maybe all of this is required. The audience is different. So first, which is our segment, our target segment? Then what are we creating for them? How are we educating the buyer today about what we are creating and the various components involved in the pricing thereof? I think all of this is very important, but equally important is making sure that, like I said, it's all about people. So one part of that people puzzle is the buyer. The other part is the brokers. Are they educated enough? Are we making sure that they are going and presenting what needs to be presented? Are they well looked after? Have after RERA, some of them just become interior designers, others have started opening these business centers in spaces which they had bought earlier. Are they changing their line of business? Are they still around to do this? What are we handholding this trade through this journey? That also becomes a big brother role of the developer. To hold the trade which you created and which for generations was working like that. It's like the jewelry business. Some of the brokers are like wealth managers, five generations, that's all they've done. But are we making sure that the new generation is running away? So the brokers we have to hold together. Very, very important. Then the pool, Gagan, very, very important is that the employees, that the developers, I remember when I started in this line, there was so much training which used to go on. In fact, I just met somebody in the audience who said he and I attended a training program in some year long back. So the point I'm trying to make is that talent pool available? For every other industry, there's a trained pool available. For our industry, Prashant ji just mentioned about possessions. You know, you want to hand over 1,000 homes in 30 days, the OC comes, everybody has to be given their house, everyone wants to be the first one. Is there a proper system of snag listing, of hand holding, of seeing them through, you know? Ease of purchase for the customer. First understanding their requirement and then ease of purchase. Can he just go to a portal? Can he fill in an application form? Is his interest preserved? Is there clarity on stock, or some hidden good apartments are lying somewhere and he's only choosing from whatever is being shown to him? So many things. So transparency is another part. Now, if all of this is in place, I think we are ready for the next jump where you say that, okay, you know, is the road good for the developers? I think the road is brilliant, you know. And I think I would take this opportunity to really thank Mr. Anurag Batra, the Realty Plus team, for completing their 10 years. And yesterday was the 10th. Our Navratras have just started. This is going to be the test. This season for us, starting from yesterday and going on till about February, is going to be a real test for all the developers, for all the brokers, about, you know, what this year has been like for us. And I think we should all do our best. And my best wishes to all my industry colleagues that it should be a really bumper crop for everybody.
Thanks, thanks. Thanks, Ananta. You know, we now listen to a different perspective. So, you know, when on a lighter note, when Ananta talked about driverless cars, I started smiling in my mind whether the driverless cars in NCR are going to be programmed to overtake and cut across lanes, etc., because that is what we are synonymous with. But we come to Augustine, who's been listening patiently, and Augustine, while the challenges may be slightly different in the market that you are in, what are some of the thoughts you'd like to share with the audience, with the rest of us, about what's been different, what's been common, success stories that you'd like to share with the people here?
Well, the one thing which is common is the word survival. I guess it's happening across the country. We are as much as in the same boat as anybody else. But that's by and large, I think we are going through a systemic correction at this point of time in the country. And along with that, coupled with that, is the economic slowdown. I think it's a bad combination. Otherwise, it would have been a great thing to have a systemic correction with a good economy would have been much better. But however said and done, I think we are all trying to figure out what is the best way to make profit, because at this point of time, like him, the new generation ones, I clearly see that they can flourish because they have no baggage. Developers with baggage can't really run fast as much as he can run, because they have to complete the earlier commitments. And that's weighing down on people more than anything at this point of time. Again, there are categories. People who have a traditional land bank can still survive. People who have to acquire new land will face a different challenge in terms of pricing. Because today we're in a situation where the input cost is pretty high. The taxation is phenomenally high. The prices are low, the profit margin is low, but the demand for housing is pretty high. So that's inherent. As a India, as a country, I think as a nation, we are going to have a very high demand going forward. So we've experienced the 25 years of economic liberalization, and we are going to only get the best of that going forward in the next 10 years. Having said that, but these challenges are far more weighing. So, in Mumbai, I think a lot of formats have changed. So, like in our group now, we say, if the profit margins are lower, you sell faster. Don't hold. So, sell as much as you can when you start, so that you self-fund your project, so you bring down your cost. Because we have to now build efficiencies in projects. That's the only way you can make money, not by increasing the price. So, you find a method to make money within the given situation. So what we do is, if the profit margins are lower, you sell faster,
reduce your borrowing cost and complete the project. So the mantra right now is, I think across the country we were all doing launches. I mean, more than 20 years in this industry, I only used to listen to, we are launching. So-and-so is launched, he's going to launch. We are all working on launches. I rarely heard people saying, I've handed over 1,000 apartments. I've handed over 5 projects. I've handed over 10 projects. But I think now there is a paradigm shift. Everyone is talking about, I have to hand over, and I'm handing over, I've handed over. So there's a complete difference in the way we're looking at. And also, even in terms of pricing, I think now we are ready to listen to the consumer more than at what price I want to sell. Even in terms of the product, I think we have started taking the consumer a little more seriously rather than this is what I want to sell and this is the price at which I want to sell. We want to take it or leave it. So I don't think that is anymore that luxury is not available to us. So in our group, what you have started doing is we have started thinking a little ahead. For example, our projects will now have electric car charging by default in our projects. All our projects will, by default, will be iGreen, which is a combination of a smart home with a green home or a smart office with a green office. So that will become by default because we are seeing the trend changing. And when a consumer comes to us now, when even in terms of advertising, we are no more talking to that the head of the family who used to sign the checks maybe 5-10 years back. Now the son also has a say, the daughter has a say, or if the children are now going to get married, they even think through to someone who's going to come into the family. So you have to convince the wife, the husband, and the children. So you have to communicate to 4 different people in the same family. And 4 people may favor 4 different developers. So the entire scenario is changing. It's not the same anymore. So we have started changing our product in a way we can even talk to the future generation, not just the one who's going to sign. So he's going to get up and say, Papa, don't buy here. This developer is not good. Rather, let's look at that. Let me go Google. Let me see what is his track record. You know, let me go into RERA. Let me see what he is giving is, you know, is listed there. So we are staring at a new consumer altogether. So our communication is changing. Our product, the way we are designing is changing because we are very clear as to we are now talking to the consumer and saying, listen, when you have your child who's 4 years, 5 years, now they're all playing with mobiles. So we are looking at a futuristic product, yet more, yet still be profitable. So our strategy is to say 1/3 should be sold in the first 6 months. The next 1/3 should be sold in the construction period, and the last 1/3 be sold on possession, because again you can sell it without GST and all of that. So maybe that could become your profit, and your first 1/3 can actually take care of your construction of the entire project. So we follow different methods right now as to how do we bring in efficiency and still see some profit in the projects. That's what is happening.
No, very, very, very interesting, and you know, some of the stuff you shared just put a different perspective to light, which is what you're doing, what is the new kind of construction. Now, the person who's been waiting very patiently is the person who can probably take a little more dispassionate view, because while you're involved with this industry, you are also involved with a lot of other industries. Right. So why don't you share a little bit of what, from an outside perspective, do you make of the challenges which are grappling with the industry, and what can the industry do better?
Right. Thank you so much, and good evening, everyone. So, very rightly pointed out, I'm sitting amongst a very, very passionate group of individuals who are in this industry. So, okay, now to add to what they have been saying and keeping the passion intact. So, as a lawyer, we usually tend to look at like he said, things dispassionately, internally, like the way we look at things negatively. That's what most people think. So just to kind of retrace our steps a few years back, and I think Mr. Agarwal rightly pointed out one thing, that every industry has its own regulator, right? Like So securities and capital markets industries has SEBI. The banking industry has RBI. And until a few years back, all the real estate industry had was a consumer forum, right? So that is precisely what was kind of governing any consumer or any buyer when it comes down to, you know, investing in properties. So the first step when RERA came in and you know, I would, so any new legislation which kind of gets passed in the country, you never see the positives immediately. Like, for example, I'll take a very, very simple example. If you remember the time when, you know, cell phones became a menace and, you know, people were getting fined for using the cell phone while driving, right? So if you notice that the maximum challans happened around that time. So these days you don't get challaned for, you know, usage of cell phone. Either people have started using Bluetooth or that they've now realized that they have to now fall under, you know, a certain acceptance of traffic rules. And so, you know, there is this automatic, you know, falling in line that happens, right? So that is precisely what happened when RERA came in, right? So, like Mr. Tiwari also pointed out that, and Mr. Agarwal, that when RERA came in, there was this entire purge which happened. And RERA coupled with IBC, then NCLT also being there, the consumer forums also working overtime, and RERA not being implemented like the way it was thought. It takes time. In India, it takes time. And there were many, many issues. Like, for example, I think Kerala, they came out with their own legislation on RERA, which was considered to be, hugely, I would say disproportionate to what the central RERA wanted to implement, and they had to call it off. I think there's something similar which is happening in West Bengal. I think there is a certain citizens' forum. Sorry?
They're quite watered down.
They've watered down the provision. So again, there's a citizens' forum which has, which has come up in arms, and they're like, we want to modify this. So things take time, but the good thing is, like they pointed out, that this purge ensured that people who only had land banks and suddenly wanted to become developer are out of the game.